In this part, we will start with the male reproductive system. Male reproductive system. Now, male reproductive system comprises of the primary sex organ, that is a pair of testes. So, they are two in number. This is the primary sex organ, and the function of this primary sex organ is to produce gametes as well as hormones. So it is going to produce the male gametes, that is sperms, and the male sex hormones. So these two functions are performed by the primary sex organ, that is a pair of testes. Now, to help this primary sex organ, there are some accessory or helping sex organs, which are known as secondary sex organs or accessory sex organs. So, secondary sex organs include certain structures and glands. So, here it would include epididymis, then glands like seminal vesicle, prostate gland, one more small gland is there, which is again in pair, and that is called Cowper's glands. These are the structures which are going to help. And then there are some ducts which will help in conduction of this sperm. So the ducts actually include, there are many, two of them we are not writing here. We'll write them when we draw the internal structure of testes. So we are writing vas deferens. Then we would also write down about the urogenital duct. And why we are calling it urogenital duct? Because in case of males, it is a common passage for conduction of urine as well as for the sperm. So it is a common passage, and that's why this term. So these are all the organs which are there. And then there is one more structure which is called the external genitalia, and that is the penis. This is external genitalium, which helps in insemination, that is deposition of sperm into the female body. So this is how the various parts are. Now let us come to the first part, that is the testes. Now when we are talking about this primary sex organ, they are in pairs, small oval structures. So if we write it here, these are small oval structures, approximately 4 to 5 centimeters long, and they are located outside the abdominal cavity in scrotal sac. So this is what we are writing about the testes, located in scrotum. Scrotum is a pouch-like structure which is made up of a thin skin and a muscle layer. We'll talk about this in detail. So, a pair of testes located extra-abdominal in case of humans. That is extra-abdominal, outside the abdominal cavity. Now, when we talk about this structure, the two scrotal sacs. So this is one sac and this is the other sac, and they are separated by, again, a thin membranous fold which is known as the scrotal septum. And these are the two compartments, or these are the two pouches. Each one is going to hold one testis. Normally, one testicle is little lower as compared to the other one. So there is a level difference, and this is specifically to prevent squeezing of these testes if some external pressure is applied. And because they are outside the abdominal cavity, there are connection with which it is connected to the abdominal cavity. So from here, there is a connection. Here is the abdominal cavity, and this is the connection from where this cavity is connected to the abdominal cavity. These canals or these connections are known as inguinal canal. These are called inguinal canals. Inguinal canal is a connection between the scrotal sac, the cavity, and the abdominal cavity. This scrotal sac has a cavity. This cavity is known as vaginal coelom. And this vaginal coelom is filled with a tissue. The tissue is known as hydrocele. I'm not drawing this hydrocele right now. Once we draw the testis here, after that we'll fill that space. And in this cavity is this oval structure which we call the testis. One is going to be here, the other is here. So they lie in this coelom, which is called vaginal coelom, the cavity. And now let us draw that tissue in which this testis are embedded. So this is the hydrocele, the tissue which is surrounding it. Now, how are these testes placed or fixed here? The testicles are formed in the embryonic stage. They descend later on. So when the male fetus is developing, then the testes are formed in the abdominal cavity. Scrotal sac is empty at that time. But during embryonic development, these testes, they descend into the scrotal sac. And after they descend, they have to be fixed here. So they are fixed with the help of a fibrous band, which is known as gubernaculum. So this structure is gubernaculum. Gubernaculum fixes the testes in that scrotal sac. There is one more structure which helps, and that is called the spermatic cord. Spermatic cord is actually a big, thick cord-like structure here through which the arteries also come in, through which the veins also leave, through which vas deferens also leaves. So it is a big band-like structure. So that this one and gubernaculum both keep the testis in their position. And the tissue which is surrounding is the hydrocele. Each testis is surrounded by a thick fibrous layer. We will draw this again in detail when we come to the detailed structure. And this layer is known as tunica albuginea. Tunica albuginea. And outside this tunica albuginea is present one more layer, which is known as the tunica vaginalis. So there are two layers which protect. This is tunica vaginalis. So this is how the testes are placed in the scrotal sac. Reason why these testes are extra abdominal is very important. The reason is for spermatogenesis, the temperature which is required is 2 degrees approximately below the body temperature. So this extra abdominal position of testis, this extra abdominal is required for spermatogenesis. And why this is required for spermatogenesis? Because this process, it takes place at a temperature which is 2 degrees Celsius below the body temperature. So, extra abdominal condition is essential so that spermatogenesis takes place. We will talk about certain abdominal conditions when the testes fail to descend. We'll see what happens in those conditions. Now, What exactly is that structure which is holding the testis in its position? One is gubernaculum and other is the spermatic cord. And one more important thing which we have to remember in this case is that the temperature of that scrotum is maintained by the muscles of the scrotal sac. So, temperature of scrotum is maintained by deltoid muscles. These muscles, they are very thin. So, these deltoid muscles, they are thin skeletal muscles which are present in the scrotum. So, scrotum is a thin skin pouch, but it has this muscle also. So, now we know the position of the testis. Behind this, we'll quickly go over this thing also. If you're looking at the scrotum from the anterior side, behind the testis is present the epididymis, that is the secondary sex organ or the accessory sex organ. So, it is going to be behind this. And if it is behind it, we won't be able to show that structure. So, we will draw a diagram in which we show it in such a manner that if this is the testis that we draw, the epididymis is shown here. So, this is going to be the anterior side and this is the posterior side. So, epididymis is behind it, behind the testis. So, from the posterior side only, it is going to be visible. And then the ducts are going to carry that, those sperms which will be produced here. So from here, when the sperms are produced, they will be taken by a duct. The duct is going to go back into the abdominal cavity. Here, around the urinary bladder, it is going to take a loop. And then it is going to come out from here, where that external genitalium or the penis is present, through which there is a tube which is going to pass, and that tube is going to bring the sperms through the vas deferens and the urine from the bladder. We will draw that diagram later once we have understood all these parts. So, in the next part, we will see the detailed structure of the test.